in like PSM, there were questions on like there is a flood in Kerala and all those type of questions were there. What could you
Exactly.
do? So there were a lot of application based questions on really common topics, which we, you know, we need to focus on a lot. Hi guys, I'm Dr. Arjun Kumar Agarwal from SMS Medical College, Jaipur, and I have secured 712 score out of 800 and a tentative rank of 2, All India, fingers crossed that is. And also I secured a first rank in UPSC CMS for this year also, for which result was announced in March and April.
Wow,
So
congratulations for that.
thank you, sir. Thank you
First
so
rank in
much.
CMS also.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, how will you rate this exam, first of all?
Sir, it was, I think it was a little on the easier side. I mean, not on the easier side in the sense the topics that have been asked were easier and the common topics were asked, but in an application-based manner. Like, how would we, you know, apply things in the real life situation? In like PSM, there were questions on like there is a flood in Kerala and all those type of questions were there. What could you
Exactly.
do? So there were a lot of application-based questions on really common topics, which we, you know, we need to focus on a lot. Or there can be no exam in which there is not a question on aortic dissection or tension pneumothorax, or either one of them. They have to be there. It's so important. There has to be, you know, questions on some topics. You have to focus on those topics. So, but they asked in a twisted manner.
So it pretends easy, but the options were twisted, sort of.
Exactly. Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
So you should know like deep knowledge, then only you can be able to
Yes,
extract
sir.
the
Like,
right answer.
yes,
But the
sir.
topics were frequent ones.
Topics were very frequent ones. I don't think they were very, very, you know, unexpected topics. Every paper will have some or the other here and there, but most of the questions I felt that they were heard of. Unheard questions were, I don't think they were a much, a bunch of them might be there, but yeah, most of them were heard of, or the topics were heard of, and about the whole scenarios were heard of.
So, how many number of questions you attempted? Like
Sir, I attempted 198.
198. Two left.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Two
Sir,
left to whom?
actually, so this is the actual thing. Well, like the difference, I think, between 1, 2, and 3 is that I think that is what I think I can calculate that the person who has the highest score, he left 4 question and has 182 correct, and I did 182 correct and I left 2 questions, and so I have 5, 7, 1, 2, and the person on 7, 10 must have, you know, corrected 182 and would have left none. So
Okay.
this is the this is so this was so close in that battle. Yes,
The
sir.
top ranks are always close, like.
Yes, sir.
But definitely, as you have achieved up in CMS, also the first rank, definitely some formula you know that how to be in the top ranks. So if you want, you can share on that formula.
There is no such secret formula, I guess, which can apply to, you know, everyone and all. But somehow we tend to, you know, step by step, it's all a step by step approach. If, oh, I cannot say that the day I started, I would have thought that I can get, you know, into the top 3. I always thought that I wanted to work for something and I wanted to work hard. And what I wanted to work hard was exactly not the results, because I still believe that the happiness I'm feeling right now is nowhere would be compared as I would feel happiness the day I save my first life. That would be the actual day that my actual, you know, what I believe my knowledge would come to. So this has been the most important stepping stone for this, and the most important result for me of all time. But that is the happiness that I'll always look to save that one life. So I always thought that I want to work hard for that. So step by step, it goes on increasing. So I always thought that I'll go in that manner.
So can you share up your like from the first year and all which things you focused on and all
Yes, sir.
in a short term?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So in the first year, basically, first year, though, it goes, it comes and goes, you don't know.
Right.
Then in second year, towards the end of the second year, I started to get a little, you know, an idea that we have to do PG. Till then, I had no idea that there's something that we have to do after MBBS. I thought that Agex Medical College, mein, we are all
After
set.
value.
And so that was something that I was enlightened to in the end of the second year.
Right.
So I kind of started doing the things which I had not done previously. I started reading some standard textbooks, which I thought would open my mind to the, you know, subject. I always, wanted to open my mind to subjects and things which can help me, which I thought helped me answer some of the questions which I have not read. If I have an open mind to a subject, I always feel that I can score that extra 5 marks or extra 5 questions of the topics that I don't know just based on the subject as a whole. So I always tried for that. After that, in third year, I started my regular coaching classes. I always like the idea of live classes. Somehow back then, there was no culture of video lectures as such. Mm-hmm. But I really liked the live classes. So I attended the live classes, sir. And I was almost able to complete all the subjects of first 3 years, apart from FMT and microbiology, thankfully. I'll tell you why, sir. Thankfully, I did not do microbiology in third year. And in final year, I did, and third year also, I did medicine also, a major chunk of it. And in final year, sir, I completed rest of the subjects. And then you took the class in final year, micro class in Jaipur, at Jaipur Center. You had not taken it in third year. So I was so thankful that I had not attended any class of microbiology before that. So I attended your class. I think it was somewhere I had my PUCs 1 month after the classes, but I had to attend because it was you who was coming and I could not miss that. Mm-hmm. So I attended. It was probably the best experience, like the best decision I took to attend your class. It was 3 days microbiology, and like me and my friends always say that no notes in my whole preparation is, you know, so highly everything. I felt just not microbiology, the way you took to the infectious diseases to the level of, you know, we could solve questions of medicine, PSM and everything included. That was so wholesome, sir. That was just amazing.
Thank you so much.
So that was something that I really liked. Apart from that, sir, in internship, I had 3 subjects left mainly. I was not thorough with biochemistry and I was not thorough with FMT. Mm-hmm. And I had a doubt over PSM and I had a doubt over most subject, ophthalmology probably, yes sir. So yes sir, so for a PSM I looked up and I found that I had to go through Vivek Jain sir's videos. I had to go through because there was a lockdown, there were no live classes. So I was lucky enough that there was a period where I could access PrepLadder, and so I went through Vivek Jain sir's classes. And as much as I could write down, I wrote down, but some part of it I had to get printed because there was always a time foundation on everything. Mm. Apart from that, sir, the short subjects, which for the short subjects, I found very high yielding. The shorter the notes are, the better I thought would be the yield of the notes towards any paper, in any MCQ paper. Mm. So like in our live classes only, Swati ma'am taught us anesthesia. And apart from that, also Manish sir for Derma, and I really like psychiatry by Praveen sir. He literally took a single day class of psychiatry at life class of psychiatry, and just in one day, and such a great class, I cannot tell you, sir. So it was an amazing experience with that. So yes, sir. So I started internship, sir, and I almost had all my notes, completed some of them. Did an online question bank and focused more on the previous year questions and some topics relating to the previous year questions here and there.
What about the GTs and all?
So GTs, I have attempted, I think, of all platforms. I can say that I have attempted GTs of all mm-hmm. platforms, be it any platform. So I attempted a lot of GTs.
Which platform you like find it more relevant, simulate the exam?
Sir, it was mixer. Like yes. I really thought that one paper of one platform might sometime it was relevant. Then maybe the next GT was not so relevant. And then because the thing is, sir, that what I thought is that every platform somewhat had to make 20 grand tests in this past 1.5 years. So obviously the institute or the platform cannot make 20. Hold all the 20 relevant grand tests. They have to step up and they have to do things which probably would become irrelevant at a point of time. That goes on for all the things that I have. Like in the last 3 to 4 months, the GTs I took, a lot of things were on the tougher side. But what that did was that I could reach into the areas which I only after I was at a base level. So that was something that I that it was. But the thing, yes, sir. The thing is
Right.
that
I'm asking some irrelevant question of something like it's better
yes,
one
sir.
is to stick to basics, I suppose. What do you
Yes,
say in
sir. You
that?
can. Yes, sir. You can go into the deep of a basic topic. You can go into deep of a MI or let's say a fibroid. You can go inside deep of that instead of random XYZ topic of something. So that always I thought which helped actually in the actual paper because they were deep questions of fibroid. Like there was a question on infertility and with fibroid and what would you do to the patient. So that I thought was a good question. I really don't know if that question for me is wrong or right, but because that is totally an approach-based question. So those were the applications which I could come through with. So.
What the now your juniors will be going on to take up after 2022, the next. Okay,
Yes,
so
sir.
what's your take on that? Some students they are saying that we should skip first and second years, that we should focus on the clinical ones and all that. So what's your take on that? It should come from
Sir,
your mouth.
I don't think that is possible. A person who skips first and second year, I don't think they can make a good result for any paper, be it they say that it will be only final year of third year, because you would definitely lack the basics. Like I'll tell you an example, sir. Like in the past 2 years, the gradual trend I have seen all the previous year 3 year papers. So there has been a gradual change, especially in the last this year and the last year, that clinical questions tend to be integrated and you cannot separate subjects. You cannot separate pharma from medicine or pathology from surgery and medicine, even microbiology from PSM and medicine. You cannot separate that things. So even medicine and surgery, there was a question on Fournier's gangrene in this paper, mixed infections. Yes, sir. So we cannot separate the subjects. And if we don't have the basic knowledge of the subjects of the first and the second year, we cannot be good at the final year subjects or the third year subject. This is what I feel. And one more thing is that, sir, what I feel is that be it any exam, be it prof or be it a 200 question NEET or be it a 540 question, I think they're going to be
Yeah,
in
the
the next
next.
paper. So I don't think that that means that the number of topics will increase massively. What my, I don't really, I have not, sir, gone through much of what is going to be in the next
New
because,
one.
yes, sir, I have not gone through much what the details of it. But as far as I know as of now, that is that what I think is that if a person wants to ask a question of cardio, he would probably ask three questions of MI instead of asking one question of MI and two questions of random something, random arrhythmias, difficult arrhythmias. So this is what I feel that an important topic, be it prof exam or be it NEET, they remain the same. And questions are bound to the majority questions are bound to come from them. So those should be the areas to focus on instead of going on leaps and bounds onto things to explore here and there.
This exam is the start of next only, I suppose.
Yes, sir.
There's more of
Yes,
that
sir. Exactly. So like
integration.
I'll give you two, three examples of the questions. There was a question which I left. Somehow one of the questions which I left was that the patient on digoxin develops an arrhythmia and AFib and something like that was there. And that was a pharma-based question, but it could be a medicine question also because you are managing the patient and you have to answer a question based on drug interaction. So this is how there were a lot of integrated questions.
And I suppose there was a question in from microbiology stuff that they have given a history of measles and they have
Yes,
asked
sir.
is it a single stranded RNA, double stranded
Yes, sir.
RNA, single stranded DNA. So obviously if you know those mnemonics like which is non-enveloped viruses, which are
Yes, sir.
non-enveloped RNA viruses, DNA
Park
viruses,
Park
exactly you remember that PAP and PARC. Okay,
happened,
PAP
Park,
is for
sir.
DNA and that is for
Sir,
RNA.
you
So
are a legend here, sir. Let me tell you are a legend amongst us.
thank you so
Hello.
much, but that should be the approach, I suppose, na? Given
Yes, sir.
you should know those things, like
We
which you
have
can
to
exclude
obviously know
out,
the basics. Yes, sir.
because you
Like
can't
on
remember
me.
everybody to be enveloped, non-enveloped. But if you know that these four families are non-enveloped, then it's very easy, or
Yes, sir.
to exclude other things that
Yes,
what
sir.
I'm getting on.
Exactly my point. Yeah, and sir, also, sir, like to again reinforce my point, there were, I think, two or three questions on measles. There was a
Right,
question on measles, SSP, and
SSP,
then, yes, this one.
burst
And then
pattern
there
and
was,
all that.
yes, sir. And then there was an integration PSM on MMR vaccine not to be given in immunocompromised children. There was
Right,
one discussion also. So
right,
my point being that on measles itself or in vaccines, there were three questions. Instead of they could have asked a question on some, let's say, some random virus. Some random arbovirus, they ask a deep question that they won't do.
right.
So that is very less likely. So that is what.
That's what our topics will always remain the same. They will move around them only, and they will asking up in a different ways, different approaches, different ways.
So this is something that I see. I've come across a lot of juniors and a lot of students I've asked and talked to that they want to study everything that there is to offer, and in that process they somewhat miss out the most important things that should be the first contact things. So what I always suggest is you should go in a stepwise manner. What do you do is do a stepwise manner, in the sense do the most important things, start with the most important things, and then go on to upper levels. Like, so when I reached a decent, what I thought that, okay, I'm doing decent. I'm not doing extra. I was not doing extra great at a point of time, but I thought that I was really not good at, you know, rote learning things. But I was good at conceptualizing things and algorithmic things. So I thought I can strengthen that portion and, you know, get some extra marks here and there. So I went through some of the algorithms from standard texts. So that is something I did after I was thorough with the basics. So always in a stepwise manner, I would say that we should go.
And what about like the frequency of solving mock tests and all
for you? Sir, it went on to increase like gradually. In the first phase of the read, it was about 5 to 6 months, I guess. So in that phase, I used to give mock tests, I think, every month, one or sometimes two.
If you get less marks in some GPA.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what should be your approach like? Because people tend to have less marks and they leave out. Okay, I will not give the GPA.
So first of all, I would like to tell everyone that this is normal, perfectly normal. I myself have had dips. I've had 3 or 4 plateaus that where I was stuck at a score for a long time. 4 or 5 GTs, I was stuck at a score after my second read, I think. Even just before the exam, also, I was stuck at a score. It was neither going down and it was neither going up. So one thing I would say is that if you get a dip, that means that you have an area to improve. You have to always and always look at the positives. If you had a dip, means you were at a good level. You had a dip, means you have something to improve on. And that is not out of your reach because you're always there. And apart from that, what I thought is that staying on a plateau itself requires an effort, sir. Because we are giving 4 GTs in a span of, let's say, 1 month at a later part of the year. So staying 1 month at the same level also takes some effort. So that doesn't mean that you're not studying. That doesn't mean you're not making an effort. Because as and when all the platforms, the first GT is going to be the easiest GT, generally speaking. And the last, towards the end, not the last, but towards, you know, as they move on onwards, the GTs also start getting a little on the tougher side, little on the tricky side. Not exactly difficult, maybe a little tricky and twisted types. So that also tends to tell that if you're in a plateau, that doesn't mean you're going down. It is at that level or maybe unknowingly going up only. So no matter what, a GT can never decide. No GT in this any platform can decide or actually it cannot. So that is what I thought, and that is what I always told any of my friends who, like, we talked in between. So this was always what my take was on the GTs. That this is to, you know, stay on the path. This cannot define your path. They can never define it. But reviewing the GTs, taking out the relevant points, reviewing your mistakes, that is very important because the mistakes haunt us. If there might be a question which I marked wrong in a GT, and if I make that same mistake in the NEET exam, and whatever be my
criminal.
That's criminal. That's criminal, and that will and that can give you sleepless nights. So that's the whole point that you have to review GTs.
Students tend to ask up that, sir, can we leave some subject and we can go for the exam and all. So what's your take on that? You are a safe at rank 2 and all, tentative that particular rank. And as you can see down in the marks, those particular individuals, like on a single mark, 100,000 students are there. Okay. So that the crowding have happened up at that particular 500 mark and all that. So obviously, I suppose nobody can afford to miss out. What's your take on that?
So I don't think they should miss out. What I said is that if you cannot complete a subject, even if you have a single day for a subject, then also you can at least get...
See the major
points. Yes, sir. I think if you do the recent NEET questions and you're able to somehow read the explanation of those questions from any source, whatever you want to, whatever there's available to you, be it textbook, be it online platform, or be it recall videos. So from any platform, if you can cover those, like now there will be 1100 questions in the recent 3-4 years, and plus the aims, if they have the, they want to, that's up to you. But if you have just 1 year, then go through these recent need questions only, and that would probably get you at least 2 to 3 questions out of the 5 out of nothing. So at in a single day, out of 0 questions, you move on to 3+ questions, and that changes your rank massively. Instead of leaving a subject and going to the paper with leaving the subject, you can do this. I would like all, I always tell ki the start from the first step. The first step is always, if you don't have time, then do the recent need questions. If you have time, stick to the notes. Stick to the notes, and if you can, you know, constrict the notes. If you, as small the notes are, they're easier to revise. Like this has always been the thing that said that we tend to want to get more to read and everything. But when we have to revise the whole thing in 1 month, or let's say in the last 20 days or even 40 days, then it's very, very tough. It's very tough.
So can you, like in the last, can you give a crux motivation for your juniors, like how to go for it, and what you should not lose in this particular journey? Because I suppose it's a journey, like from the first year, you have a dream and you keep on learning the subjects. Like in a crux, like what sort of motivation you would give them? Because a lot of fellows, they could not able to qualify also, and a lot of them are there. Like what they should do, because next this NEET PG is like just approaching up, so they have a limited time. So what best step you can give to them?
Sir, what I can say is that the first of all, you have to believe. There will be a lot of people in this world who might look down upon you, but one of them can never be yourself. If that, you should never be the person to look down upon yourself. We have to believe that. So if you believe that, you have to trust yourself, have faith in your capabilities, and then have a smart way to, you know, approach things. Do it in the stepwise manner. 6 months is an ample amount of time if you use them in a smart way, and it can be a meager amount of time if you use it to, you know, to cover everything. And you will not get the result. I would suggest is, you know, stick to the basics. You, if you don't have much time, you are, if someone is in a job, then try to revolve around the previous year questions. My example being, like, there has been question on measles this year, 2 years. It is not possible that measles has not been repeated in the past 3 years. That is not possible.
It's always
and so, yes, sir. Same goes for a fibroid in obs gyne, or let's say a normal labor or presentation in obs gyne, or the MI in medicine. So focus on these things. You take up subject by subject, go through previous year questions, and take out the topics you need to do and do them deep.
Some topics you tend to forget. What to do for them?
So like I was never good at, you know, learning lists and everything. I used to leave out that choda nahi karna, list nahi karna. Mnemonic mein bana leta, but I could not remember the mnemonics. So class mein aapne bana ke gaye, वो याद रहेगा, मेरे को खुद के निमोनिक्स नहीं याद रहेगा. मतलब निमोनिक्स का स्किल होता है, निमोनिक्स बनाने का एक स्किल है सर. तो निमोनिक्स इफ पीपल कैन मेक फॉर थिंग्स, इवन स्टूपिड निमोनिक्स समटाइम्स टेंड टू
गेट यू
डाउन. यस सर. सो वेरी वेरी बेसिक थिंग्स वी टेंड टू फॉरगेट. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स व्हिच वी कैन डू सम मेकिंग निमोनिक्स समहाउ कोरिलेटिंग टू थिंग्स, इमेजिनिंग अ पेशेंट दैट यू आर सीइंग, और एक्चुअली सीइंग अ पेशेंट, समथिंग लाइक दैट. And things like these, which tend to, you know, help you reinforce things, apply things, they are more important, and they tend to increase the chances of retaining something more. And doing application-based questions. Mm-hmm. Like if there is a particular set of topics which I always ask, then do the extensive module on that thing. Like do a MI module, definitely. Like not only previous year, if you're weak at MI, then do the whole MI module of any platform or any book you can, whatever that is available at your source. So that is something I would suggest. In the next 6 months, stick to the basics. Don't try to cover everything. Stick to the basics. Don't lose the basics. Don't lose the previous year repeats. When I say the repeats, that is previous year repeat topics, not the exact questions. Right. And previous year repeat topics, you should not miss. Mm-hmm. Like what I did was, sir, in the last 45 days were there. In the last, until 30th September, I wanted to complete the read of my notes from cover to cover as much as I could. I could not obviously cover all the subjects, I did cover all the subjects, but I did not cover all the subjects cover to cover. But what I did was so
That's
that
not
I did,
possible. Cover to cover is
yes,
not
sir,
possible.
definitely, yes, sir. And what I did different was this time, sir, I somehow started to jot down things and topics, screenshots and photos from my notes only because I was short on time. And just I created a material based on previous week topics, just the previous year topics. That was also incomplete. That was not complete. But something was there for me to do in the next 10 days, the final 10 days. And this is what I felt. If you have one thing to do in the last 5 days, that is all the previous year topics. If you have summarized them somehow in a place, that would be a game changer. I did not summarize all of them. I was able to summarize some of them. That is what I did in the last 5 to 10 days, previous year topics and those things. And if a question was here and there, then I used to open my notes. So this is something I did, and that helped me. So if people think that it can help them also, then this is something they can try. Yes, sir.
So as such, like I used to tell in classes, like revision is the key. Okay.
Yes,
so
sir.
I used to emphasize like revision. That is what is the key is. What's
yes, sir.
Like from your side is. Is it
sir, I'll tell you. Is it I'll. Tell you this by my own example, sir. The last revision before the INI set, I had done in March for the 18th April NEET. After that, it got cancelled. And after that, INI set was also in 2 to 3 times it got cancelled. So I thought that INI set, there is a set pattern of paper and I will do retrogradely. I did not revise the whole notes. I went retrograde. I went question to question, previous year question papers. And in that way, I had a varied amount of blind spots for me. So that was something that, in addition to a lot of other factors in proper sleep, I was not able to sleep before the INI set paper, sir. And my sleep cycle was not that good before that. So in addition to all these factors, I did not get an expected result. I got a 128 rank and I could not get my branch. What I did change was that I knew that this was a mistake for me that I did not revise the notes. I should have and I could have. I had the time to revise my notes once, but I did not do that because I thought going retrograde would be better. But then I changed that and in August, I completely did my notes as much as I could. And that was, I think, what changed that for me. Plus, I really focused on the non-academic aspects of it. For me, I realized that the non-academic aspects of the things tend to become very important at the business end of the year, the exam end of the year, be it the sleep cycle, be it the health hygiene things, be it, you know, the confidence you have.
Tell something about that. Tell something.
So like I watched whole of the Euro Cup before the INI set and whole, every match of it. And those used to go up to 3:30 somewhat, 3:34, I think, yeah, around about. So my whole sleep cycle was haywire. That also played a part. I was very anxious. I was anxious because I had not revised.
Okay.
That also plays a part in your anxiousness. I was anxious because I had not revised and I realized that there might be blind spots. The things I might be missing, and that's what happened. A combination of all this and AIMS paper went haywire for me, not according to expectations. And after that, sir, I changed completely my life, sleep cycle, and all those. I started sleeping earlier, started sleeping at 10:30, 11 to wake up at 6:30, 7 in the morning. That was something I have not done in the last 4 years. But for me, that was important to do after a setback. So I gave importance to all these factors. I tried to control my anxiousness and all those things also. So that helped me. And I don't know how much part they played, but I definitely think they play a part. Confidence also, sir, I think plays a lot of part. I have seen people who, when low on confidence, they went to 140, 144 correct out of 200. And on similar level of papers, on a higher side of confidence, they go up to 155 questions correct. I have seen that with people, and that is actually true. So keeping a good confidence is actually beneficial. Underconfidence and overconfidence, both are detrimental. Optimum amount of confidence is very important.
And revision, constant revision.
Yes, sir. Revision, sir.
Yes. Constant revision. Thinking.
Yes, sir.
You should have your notes, and handmade notes is good, like a printed notes is good as well.
Sir, there is no comparison with respect to handmade notes, but the main point being the time. I always have been an ardent supporter of live classes. Although there might be some of them complaining that topics are not covered, topics are left out in the class. But what I felt was that because those topics were left out, I could home my notes. I could compile them. I could complete them myself. So they became more of my notes. Like I have compiled PSM. I have compiled PSM, keeping Vivek Jain sir stem. I have used, I have, like I, for me, PSM was a subject which I thought had the highest yield. So I had to, and I wanted to, you know, not miss out on PSM questions. So I had to compile them. But that is something you do when you're done with the basics. When you're thorough, you're at a certain, okay, you're doing decent and you can, you know, strive for more. You can take a step up.
Arjun, what's your take on like a PrepLadder app? Like,
Sir, PrepLadder app has been very helpful, sir. I, like I said, I did Vivek Jain sir's class. Sir, actually, there was a championship examination in starting of the year in 2020, April or May. So in that, I got a decent rank. So PrepLadder provided me with free access. So I had access to all the video contents and question bank. Although I could not go through the question bank due to the constraints of time, I did attempt some GTs off and on whenever my schedule was, I could fit in the schedules. And I attended some lectures, random lectures. I attended Vivek Jain sir's, almost quite a lot of it. I attended sir forensic toxico part I attended. And some of your lectures, I also asked you once in the group because I wanted to ask about respiratory system and all those things. So I also went through that part. So here and there, bits and pieces I have done from whichever
thought that I have. Rapid revision? Have you done the rapid revision?
Sir, I have not gone through rapid revision as such. Yes. But I think rapid revision could be a boon for the people who are starting now for, you know, the...
Those who are giving the exam in six months, that can be a game changer.
It can be a boon for them. Like I said, because I don't know about rapid revision as such, but rapid revision would be is that all the esteemed faculties would combine the most important things and the most high yielding topics into that thing. So obviously this is something for a person who is starting now, and time is short. Like if you can make six months an ample amount of time. So to make that, this might be a good way to go about it, and like the shorter versions of things. So that is, and doing the previous year questions with that. And it can be a meager amount of time if you want to cover everything and end up nowhere. So this is something which might be, you know, very important to some people who are starting now. Yes, sir.
And what about which branch you... going to take up? Sir, some talks are going on, or you decided?
Sir, I have not. I have some things in mind, and I'll talk with my family. I'll talk with and then come on to a final decision. Sir.
So wonderful talking to you. And
same, sir, the pleasure is all mine, sir. It is an honor. Sir.
Keep boosting up the confidence of your juniors, and yes, sir, best definitely. Of luck for your life. And
thank you, sir.
Now
thank
don't be so anxious. Much. Now you are in the rank two. And
yes, sir.
And best of luck to you, sir. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir.